Okay, so hello everyone. Welcome to BBLSI Design Lecture Number 29B. Today we are going to implement a two-input AND gate using Domino CMOS logic. So that means we have to implement F is equal to A dot B using Domino CMOS logic. Okay, so here is a simple procedure. First, we add implement a pull-down network for A dot B using NMOS transistors. Next, we apply add MP and MN transistors. And apply clock to the gate terminal. Next, we add the static CMOS inverter at the node X, and we next add capacitance Cout at the output node. So in short, this is what we meant. So first part over here is my dynamic logic, and I've just added a static inverter at the output. This complete circuit will give us the AND gate implementation of using Domino logic. Okay. So I repeat over here, we have the precharge transistor named as MP, which is a PMOS transistor whose gate terminal is connected to the clock, source terminal is connected to the VDD, and the drain terminal is connected to the internal node X. Then that is followed by the pull-down network, which consists of two NMOS transistors in series with the input A and B, and their names are M1 and M2, and which is followed by MN transistor, which is an evaluate transistor, and whose gate terminal is connected to the clock, and the source terminal is connected to the ground. And then followed by this first stage, internal node is my X, wherein we have internal node capacitance, which is Cx, and the voltage across that is Vx. Now that is feeded to the static CMOS inverter. And at the output of the static CMOS inverter, we have connected another output capacitance Cout. The voltage across that is Vout. So finally, in terms of logic expression, we will get at the output F equal to A dot B. Now, the total transistor count required to implement two input AND gate is 6. How 6? Domino logic requires for n input, it requires n plus 4 transistors. Okay. So if we have two inputs, it will require 2 plus 4, that is 6 transistors. And that is what is exactly which we have over here, 6 transistors. Okay. Now let us analyze the working in the precharge phase. So in the precharge phase, clock is 0. So my PMOS transistor MP is on and MN is off. Now, irrespective of the values of A and B, output internal node X unconditionally charges to VDD via MP transistor, okay, with the help of Cx. So at the voltage across the capacitor Cx, which is Vx, is tending towards VDD, the VDD or logic one. So this VDD is applied to the gate terminal, which is logic one. So output of the CMOS inverter will give us logic 0. That means if we apply the 5 volts over here or VDD volts or logic 1, your MN1 transistor will be on and the output will be, your capacitor will be discharging towards the ground via this MN1 transistor. Okay. So hence at the output, we get F equal to 0 or Vout equal to 0 volt, irrespective of A and B. Now, let's check what happens in the evaluate phase. So in the evaluate phase, let's say we have a clock as 1. So let's say both the inputs A and B are also 1 and 1. That means if clock is 1, MP transistor is off. So internal node X is disconnected from VDD and MN transistor is on over here. And A and B is also 1 and 1. So M1 and M2 is also on. Hence, the internal node X discharges towards the ground via M1, M2 and MN transistor. So hence the voltage across this capacitor Cx is tending towards 0. That is Vx is 0. So when we apply a 0 volt to a CMOS inverter, output will be obviously logic 1. How it is? 0 volts will activate this PMOS transistor, which is MP1, and that will charge the output node towards the VDD level. Okay. So for 1 and 1, for AND gate, you at the output, you get a logic 1. At the output, we get a logic 1. Exactly what we are getting over here. Okay. Now, let us consider some other cases. So, in this case, we have A and B as 0, 0, clock is 1. So, MN transistor is on, but pull-down network is off. So, this internal node X should hold the recharge value of VDD or 1. Okay. And whenever we get a logic 1 to the CMOS inverter, again, my MN1 transistor will be on and the output voltage will be tending towards 0. Okay, so that is why Vout is 0 or F is equal to 0. We can say this. So for input 0 and 0, we get output as 0, logic 0. Again, same story with 0 and 1. in spite of B being on, they are connected in series. So if one of them is off, the whole pull-down network is off. Hence, the internal node X should remain at the pre-charge value of VDD, and that is fed to a static inverter, so at the output will get a zero. Next, last case, we have A as 1 and B as 0. So in this case, we have, again, the pull-down network is off. So node internal node X should hold the value of VDD, and this value of 1 is applied to the CMOS inverter, which will be giving an output of 0 again. So the entire functionality of AND gate is completed. Yeah, this is the truth table, logical truth table, and in terms of voltages. So here we can clearly see for AND gate, if the inputs are 1 and 1, then only the output is 1, else the output is 0. Okay, so in terms of voltages, for voltages A and B as 5 and 5 volt, only then the output is 5 volt. Okay, and we have plotted over here clock A, B, X, and F. So this we will simulate in LTSpice, and we'll see this behavior of the circuit as per this waveforms. Okay, so let us start. So already the circuit has been ready for your reference over here. So this is the transistor level implementation of a AND2 gate using Domino CMOS logic. Okay, so we have given a clock over here to both PMOS pre-charge transistor and NMOS evaluate transistor. We have inputs A and B. We have internal node VX, and this is followed by a static inverter. Okay, and yeah, so we have given the pulse A and B. Fine. So let us see now. And we have given the internal node capacitances also and output node capacitances also. And the number of transistors required over here are 6. As you can see it clearly, we require 2 PMOS transistors and remaining 4 NMOS transistors. So let us quickly simulate this implementation of an AND2 gate using Domino CMOS logic. I remember AND2 means 2 input AND gate. So good, let me go to simulate. Click on run. And then I will take the screen up and keep on start plotting with A. So I will require actually 5 plots. A, B, sorry. This would be B. Then we have a clock. Then we also want to check the internal node voltage Vx. And finally, it will be Vout. So from this, we cannot judge what is what. So we have to divide this into planes. So right click, add plane plot. We'll add 5 planes so that we will distinctively, you know, check all the cases. Okay. So first is your VA, followed by VB, followed by clock, followed by VX. And at the last case, we have Vout. Okay. If you note carefully, VX and Vout will be opposite of each other. If you see very, very carefully, let me just plot a brown color. Okay. So if you see carefully, VX and Vout are exactly opposite. It should be, because VX is the voltage before the inverter and Vout is the voltage after the inverter. So whatever is VX, opposite will be the Vout value. Okay. Now let us check in terms of the table. Let me minimize this and extend it over here. And let me expand this thing. Okay. So we have one more thing before we go on to the working. So summarize, if you want to summarize this, we can implement the following function. Internal node X value will be clock bar plus A dot B bar dot clock. Okay. This A dot B bar will vary according to the Boolean expression. So when a clock is 1, X is equal to A dot B bar, which is evaluation phase. And when a clock is 0, X is equal to VDD. Now, since a static inverter is connected at node X, F is equal to X bar. Okay. So when the clock is 1, F is equal to A dot B. And when the clock is 0, F is equal to 0. So this is what in sort the entire summary of a two input AND gate using Domino CMOS logic. Now, let us verify these things. So let me keep it small over here. Okay. So this says that whenever the clock is 0, whenever the clock is 0, so clock is 0 over here. Okay. So irrespective of the, inputs A and B, my output Vout will be 0. So here it is. When the clock is zero, the output is zero over here. Okay, very, very clearly. Let me take one cursor for the output. Yeah. So output is zero. 12.51 nanovolt is as good as zero. Now, this is for entire clock period whenever it is zero. So whenever we have clock as one, we have entered the evaluate state. So depending upon the input A and B, now A and B is 1 and 1. So obviously output will be 1 and Vx will be 0, where we can clearly see. Now in next case, again when the clock is 0, for the entire duration of clock being 0, my output will be 0. So as you can see very clearly, so output will be 0. Let us check again when the clock is 1 and A is 0, B is 1. So output will be 0 because it is an AND gate and Vx will be 1. Very simple. Next, we have A as 1 and B as 1. And we have output as 1 very clearly. And Vx is opposite 0. Then again, we can come back to your clock is 0. Again, we come back to as clock as 1. So here the clock is 1, but A and B are like 1 and 0 over here. Here it is 0 and 1. So you can see very clearly output is a 0 for the remainder of the cycle. Okay. So this way we can verify the truth table and the logical expression for your domino CMOS logic. I hope that this was clear and the funda is clear from the waveforms itself. So this exactly, these waveforms are nothing but similar to what I have drawn over here. They are one and the same actually. So here I have drawn some waveforms, exactly the same they are, okay? These are the same waveforms. Only thing is I have written zeros and ones over here. So that's the only case. Rest, everything is same. Okay. So here you can, if they're asking you for 10 marks, explain domino CMOS logic with the help of waveforms and the operation in the precharge and the evaluation phase, then it is necessary to draw these waveforms also, showing that whenever the clock is zero, we are in the precharge phase. And whenever the clock is one, we are in the evaluate state. And it has to be very, very clear over here. Okay. So in this way, we can explain this with the help of waveforms. I guess, I think we have covered everything with respect to transistor level implementation of a two input AND gate using domino CMOS logic. Okay. We have covered and summarized it using the equations also, logical equations. And we have considered all the cases. Okay, so I guess that will be all for this session. Next time we will see some more concepts related to the domino logic. So until then, have a good day and thank you.